who now has turned the corner in becoming the pioneer. And it is something that we must, with your help, continue to work on so that it becomes the gateway to our aspirations and hope for restorative justice. What happened from Hamburg? Let's look back at what happened. Essentially, what was hatched here in Hamburg and implemented with a sense of heartlessness in the then Indo-Bavarian and the Mapaland had negative impacts on the Nama and Bavarian communities that continues to linger today. What was hatched here and executed was an expedition to go and conquer and seize all productive lands in the Hirovazere and the Mapaland at all costs. What was hatched here and implemented fully was an idea to disenfranchise the Obahero and Nama communities in their own nation states of the day. And finally, what was hatched here and implemented was a plan to wipe out these communities from the face of Mother Namibia. Which became apparent was the only way for Germany to achieve their objectives of conquering and seizing land as the people started to resist. Resistance was not born out of arrogance and stubbornness. It is another lesson that we get from history that any person in a privileged position, in a position of privilege, never gives that up without a fight. It was our right and privilege to live freely and safely in Mother Namibia, as it were, in the Hirovazere, in the Mapaland then. So it was a privilege we had to defend. And that became the reason for what later became a genocide. And I'm saying this with all due piece of comfort because the fact that there was land taken away, the fact that people were killed in a genocidal fashion, are things that we can all bear witness to today and cannot be, one cannot fear to say that. It is not someone sitting here theorizing about what could have happened. It is someone telling the reality of the people that we're seeing here today. When in the process of defending the privileges and rights, our people took up arms and attacked German settlers. In 1904, initially in Okahanga, later along the White Moso River, in the Omaru district, and the Zoropa area. Our Nama communities also decided to resist towards the end of 1904 and 1905. When that happened, and whereby we realized the limitations of his tombs, the city of Hamburg played another crucial role. The preparation and implementation of the total onslaught. It was from here, in the harbor city of Hamburg, that additional troops were shipped to the Hirovazere and the Mapaland. It was from here that horses and camels were shipped, which later became significant weapons of destruction, as they were used to pursue our people to the harsh conditions of the Kalahari Desert, to which they were condemned to perish. The question, which was used to contaminate waterways, was shipped from here in Hamburg. And finally, and probably one of the things that made Hamburg so connected to this is that the man who carried out this hideous crimes was interned into this city and memorialized through buildings dedicated. And that is why the struggle for restorative justice of our communities cannot escape a direct line back to Hamburg. And that is why the process of German emancipation from this brutal colonial history could not have started at any other place or in any other city than the city state of Hamburg. Hamburg profiteered, as it were, because like many other big project being implemented anyway, and I go to the FIFA World Cup as an example, there are what we call legacy projects that remain after a FIFA World Cup. In Namibia, for example, when the FIFA World Cup went to South Africa, because it was regarded as a project for Africa, we benefited immensely by having some of our soccer fields covered with artificial turf. A head office for our football body was built. Now, the legacy projects in Hamburg, as a facilitator, as a gateway to the then or West Africa, they had to be improving infrastructure, roads, rails, warehouses, the harbor being deepened, facilities being added, factories to produce the supplies to this. And even institutions, the colonial institute, was built here to prepare people who were going to the then West Africa. I understand this is what has been turned or part of it into the University of Hamburg or University here in this town. And that is why, in conclusion, I'm saying Hamburg was the gateway to colonialism and genocide in Namibia. Hamburg, 140 years later, is the pioneer of a new chance for Germany to re-engage with Namibia in a much more kinder and human face.